Yo, how's it going guys? Adamx here, hope you're all doing well, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to fully clean reinstall Windows 10, which can improve your FPS and ping quite a lot. And before this video starts, there are some disclaimers I need to give since this guide is a little bit advanced. So, clean reinstalling Windows improves performance a ton, but it will remove all your files and apps, so you will need to back up these files on maybe Google Drive or on a USB flash drive that you have or one that you can buy. And for the apps, you could just reinstall them right after. If you have multiple storage drives or one big drive on your system like I do, then you could do a partition where you back up your files there by just moving them over, which I'll show you how to do right now. Also, to do this, you will need another empty 8GB USB flash drive to install Windows Installer on it, since we're going to use it to clean reinstall Windows. So with that being said guys, let's get into the video. So let's start by how to back up these files on another drive on your system. So to do this, you need to make sure you have enough space in that drive that you want to use to make a backup partition. So for example, I have 795GB free on my C drive, and then I have 30GB of clips that I want to back up. So to do that, you'll need to download Win Partition Tool, its link will be down below in the description. Just want to open that website, and then go over here, then click under Free Edition, click Download. Then you want to run the install setup, click OK, then you can just uncheck both of these options, we just need this one. Then you could click Next, Next, and then click Yes. And after it's done, just click Finish. And when you're in here, you want to right click on the drive you went to make a backup partition on. So for me, that would be my D drive, so I'm just going to right click on it. Then at the top, you want to click on Move slash Resize. And in here, you simply just want to drag the slider until you make sure that the unallocated space after is at least 10GB more of the actual amount of free size you need. So for example, if you have 30GB of clips, you just want to make sure that the unallocated space after is at least maybe 40GB. So just drag the slider till it says 40, and it would be fine like this. So after that, you simply just want to click OK, then under here you want to click Apply. After that, just click Yes. Wait for it to finish. After it's done, you want to click OK. You can now exit out of Win Partition Tool. Now you want to click your Windows key and X at the same time, and then click on Disk Management. And then in here, you should see the backup partition you have made having a black bar unlike the rest, so you want to right click on it, then click New Simple Volume, click Next, then click Next again, then simply just click Next again, and for volume label, you just want to name it Backup Partition. After that, click Next, then click Finish. And now you have a backup partition drive that you can now move your clips or files into it. So now let me move my trash clips into that. And now that it's done, let's download Windows on the 8GB USB. So now that I have my 8GB USB flash drive plugged in, let's go ahead and download Windows into it. So you simply just want to go into the TechBench website, its link will be down below in the description. And when you're in here, you simply just want to click on Select Type, click Windows Final, and then under Select Version, click Windows 10 2009-20H2. But if you're watching this video like maybe 3 months later, then you'll probably have different version names, so you can just select whatever you want. But what I would recommend right now for most people would be 20H2. So simply just click on it, and then under Select Edition, click Windows 10, and under Select Language, you can choose any language you want, but I'll just choose English. And then for the last one, you simply just want to choose the one that ends with x64. If you have a 32-bit system, then definitely just choose the one that ends with x32. After that, you simply just want to go on the right and click download. And now it's just gonna start downloading, and I'll be back after it's done. So now that it's downloaded, we now want to use Rufus to extract it over to the USB. Simply just click on the link down below in the description for Rufus. So when you're in here, simply just want to scroll down, and then under download, just click. After it's downloaded, you simply just want to open it. And then under device, you want to select the 8GB USB you got, and then on the right, you want to click on select, and then you want to choose the Windows 10 ISO you just downloaded from TechBench. After that, you can change the volume label if you want, so I'll just name it 20H2V2, which is the Windows ISO we're putting on this USB. So simply after that, click start, then click OK. And then basically just wait for it to finish. So now that it's done, it's gonna give you a message like this that says you need to disable secure boot in BIOS. I'm going to show you how to do that later in the video, but for now, you can just click close and then click close. And after that, you want to download the post installation pack that I will leave the link for down below in the description. So this pack will basically just include slight optimizations that we will need to do immediately after installing Windows. So simply just want to download it and then right click on it and extract it with 7-zip or WinRAR. And after that, you want to open it, and in here you're going to see get network drivers, disable updates, debloat Windows, and download GPU drivers. So you're basically going to copy this pack over to the USB, but you first need to download the network drivers so you're able to have internet when we reinstall Windows. So you simply just want to open the get your network drivers folder, and then you want to double click on check your network adapter. And when you're in here, you want to click on the arrow beside network adapters. So I use Ethernet, and I have a Realtek Ethernet adapter, so I'm just going to double click on Realtek Ethernet drivers. And I'm also going to show you how to install Intel Ethernet drivers, Intel Wi-Fi drivers, and Killer Wi-Fi and Ethernet drivers. So simply after you've double clicked on what you use, for Killer drivers, after you open the website, you just want to click download, and after that, it's simply just going to start downloading. And for Intel Wi-Fi drivers, you want to scroll down, and then you want to double click on driver 64 if you have a 64-bit system, and 32 if you have a 32-bit system. Most of you, though, are going to be on 64-bit. So simply just click download, then click I accept the terms. Exact same thing for Intel Ethernet drivers, you simply just want to click on the 64 one if you have a 64-bit system, and the 32 one if you have a 32-bit system. And lastly, for Realtek Ethernet adapters, you simply just want to open the website, scroll down, and then you want to click on Windows 10 Auto Installation Program, click on the download logo beside it, and then in here you can simply just type any fake email, so just type like anything. Then click download file, and then you just want to solve this test. So yeah, after it's done, just click OK. Now you can exit out of your browser. So after you've downloaded the drivers, you want to now drag them over to this pack. I had a Realtek Ethernet driver, so I'm just going to drag the Realtek file. Then you can now simply exit out of the pack, and now you can right click on this folder, click cut. Then you want to go into the 8GB USB that you installed Windows on it, double click on it, right click in it, and click paste. So after we've done that, you now want to go to BIOS to disable secure boot and set our BIOS to UEFI to prevent any issues while installing Windows. So you simply just want to click your Windows key and R at the same time, and then type in shutdown.exe, then space, dash R, dash FW. But before you click OK, you can open this video over on your phone, since this is going to restart your PC into BIOS. And after that, you simply just want to click OK. But I won't do it since I can't actually record what I'm going to do in BIOS, so I'm just going to show you pictures on the steps. So this is an example of how it will look on an MSI motherboard. It will look different for other motherboards, but it's simply just the same idea. You can just look around for the settings or search up Google till you find it. So for an MSI motherboard, you're simply just going to go to Settings, Advanced, Windows OS Configuration, and then Secure Boot, and make sure that Secure Boot is disabled. And then you want to also do another thing, which is set your BIOS to UEFI mode. You simply just want to make sure that this is set to UEFI. Again, if you have a different motherboard, you can just look for it in your specific BIOS or search up Google on how to do it. So after you've done that, you can now just look for the Save and Exit button, click on it, and then restart into Windows. So now that we're back here, you now want to restart into your USB to start downloading Windows. So click your Windows key and R at the same time, and then type in shutdown.exe, dash R, dash O, and then dash F, dash T, space 00. After that, you want to click OK. And when you do that, you're going to be met by a screen like this. You simply just want to click continue. And when you're back into your Windows, you simply just want to do the same command again. Just open Windows key and R, paste it, and then click OK, and then this time you're going to be met by a screen that says use a device. You simply just want to click on use a device, and if it shows two partitions for your USBs, simply just click partition 1. And after that, it's going to reboot into the USB. So when it does that, you simply just want to change these settings to what suits you best. Then in here, simply just click install now, and in here, simply just want to click I don't have a product key. And then in this tab, you want to select Windows 10 Pro. And in here, just simply check this box, scroll all the way down and click Next. And then in here, click Custom. And then in this tab, you want to select the drive that you want to install Windows on. So if you have an SSD and an HDD, make sure to always install Windows on the SSD, since this is going to be much faster. Then it's going to show you this, basically telling you that every folder and file on that drive are going to be moved into a folder named Windows.old on that same drive. You can just click OK. And then when you see the screen, you want to disconnect your Ethernet cable if you use one. We don't want to have Wi-Fi or Ethernet reaching the PC while it's installing, so it doesn't for you on a Microsoft account, which adds a ton of telemetry and unnecessary features that aren't needed for gaming. So after it's done, it's going to restart your PC multiple times, saying getting ready, starting services, stuff like that. Basically, when it's done doing all that, it's going to open a page like this. You simply just want to choose your region, then click yes. After that, simply just select your right keyboard layout, then click yes. And here you wanna select if you wanna add a second keyboard layout, but most of you are gonna just click skip. And then in the network tab, as I just said before, we don't want any Ethernet or Wi-Fi reaching the PC, so you simply just wanna click I don't have internet at the bottom left. After that, you're gonna be met by a tab like this, simply just click continue with limited setup. And in this tab, simply just put your name or whatever you wanna name your PC, then you can just put a password if you want to. And then in this tab, you want to make sure to uncheck every single setting in here. These are all kind of telemetry features that you really don't want on, since it's mostly just spying on you and the stuff you search for. So simply just uncheck everything and then click accept. So that was the Windows installation process. Now I'm going to go into that Windows we just downloaded so I can show you how we will set it up with the post installation pack. Alright, so we're now on the Windows install we just downloaded, so now let's go into the post installation pack that we put on our USB. So simply just open it, and then we want to start by one disable update. So I've already made a whole video about why you should disable Windows updates, you can go ahead and watch that video, but for now, please make sure to disable updates. There's going to be a revert pack down below in the description that you can use to enable updates back if you want. But please guys, for now, just disable updates, as updating Windows reverts optimizations and downloads pre-installed apps and even worsens performance as they keep adding updates that really just ruin gaming performance. So simply guys, double click on disable UAC, click yes, and then click yes, and then click OK. After applying it, just restart your PC and then come back to the pack. So after you've restarted your PC, now you wanna double click on to disable Windows updates. Then simply just gonna stop the Windows update service, and then it's gonna add that zwares in registry to disable Windows automatic updates. And then it's just gonna update GPE edit so these apply. And when it's done, just click enter. And to make sure that updates are disabled, you can go to settings, then go into update and security. And now it's gonna show that you can't check for updates. And if you click view configured update policies, you're gonna see that automatic updates are disabled. Now you can exit out of settings, and now you can put your Ethernet cable back in, not worrying about Windows updates just randomly running and ruining your new clean install. So now you wanna download your network drivers, so simply just go into get your network drivers folder. If you downloaded the Realtek driver, then you would need to extract it first so you can use it to update your driver. And if you installed an Intel or Killer drivers, then you would most likely just need to double click on them. So after that, double click on check your network adapter. Go into network adapters, double click on Realtek, click driver, click update driver, click browse my computer, and then you want to simply just go into the driver directory, click on the address bar right here, right click and click copy, then simply just right click and click paste in here, click next. So it says I already have the best drivers since I installed the drivers before actually showing it to you guys, since I had to install OBS and some other stuff. But anyway, after doing that, just click close, go into power management tab, disable the option at the top, then go into the advanced tab, disable advanced EEE, then click on energy efficient Ethernet, make it disabled, gigabit light, make it disabled, green Ethernet, make it disabled, scroll down, power saving mode, and make it disabled. After that, simply just click OK, and now you can exit out of device manager. And then you wanna go into 2D bloat windows. So I've already made a video about this like 2 days ago, so I'm not really going to go in depth into explaining everything about it, but anyway, let's get started. So I'm gonna start by the safe method, and then you wanna double click on uninstall apps, and then you just wanna uninstall the random apps that Windows installs for us for no reason. Alright, so now that we're done, we're left with 18 apps that we can remove with this method. So I don't wanna go over this again since I just made a video about it, but this will just let you remove the unremovable apps from settings. So if you're trying to uninstall alarms and clock, but uninstall is grayed out, you can just right click on it here and click run with PowerShell. And now you're gonna notice it's being uninstalled. So you can do the same for every single other program. And now that we're done, we are only left with 7 apps and a clean Windows install. So now that we're done with the safe method, I'm gonna now go ahead and do the advanced method. Please guys, be careful while doing this method. I've already like made 2 videos about it already, and people still mess it up because they don't listen to what I say. This advanced method removes your start menu, this look for it, there is a replacement app that I show right here, but people still didn't listen and they just skip all over that, and then comment down below, bro, why is my start menu not working? So please guys, while doing the advanced method, know that it will remove your start menu, Microsoft Store, and all the apps installed from it. So if you need any of those, simply just don't do it. Alright, to start off the advanced method, you need to open the alternative programs folder, then go into browser replacement, and if you use Firefox, just double click on download Firefox. If you use Google, double click on download Google. So I use Firefox, I'm gonna double click on download Firefox. After that, I'm gonna go into enable classic Windows control scheme. Then just hold it and drag it over to power on. Click yes and then okay. If power on doesn't open, right click on it, click properties. And here you're going to see an option saying unblock, check it, then click okay, and then try again. Alright, so Firefox is installed, you can just exit it for now. And now you wanna go into replacement, start menu, and search bar. So you can use OpenShell or start is back. What I prefer though is OpenShell, and just go on with the installation process. You can do this if you want, but I like to remove everything just leaving OpenShell menu. Solely up to you though, I just prefer it like this. After that, click next, then click install, then click finish. Alright, so now you can go back, and then double click on download VLC. Then you can just click OK, then click next, and you can honestly just uncheck these two if you want. Then click next, then click install. Then you can uncheck run VLC media player, then click finish. And now that we installed the replacement apps, we can now go back and start debloating Windows. So you could follow my steps right now if you want, but I would highly recommend just following the original video I made, since it requires a bit more explanation that I won't do in this one, since I don't want to make this video much longer than it already is. So I'm simply just gonna double click on take ownership, click enter, drag it over to power on, then click enter. Also, if power on still doesn't open, right click on it and click properties, check unblock, then click OK. And then you want to do the same for the other 6 bash files. And after you're done, you want to go into the checkup folder and then just simply make sure that all the folders have no files inside of them. And if they give an error like this, that means they don't have any files inside of them, because it simply means they don't even exist. So if you have a folder like this that has a file inside of it, you can try first deleting it individually. And if it doesn't get deleted, that usually means that the program of this folder is already running. So you simply just want to right click on your taskbar and click task manager. And then you want to end the processes of the folder name. So this is the Microsoft Edge folder. So you want to end every task that says Microsoft Edge. So let's start by Microsoft Edge update. Click end task. And then scroll down, look for anything else that says Microsoft Edge. And I can't see anything. And this one too is for Microsoft Edge. So I'm just going to right click on it and click end task. And then I'm going to click try again. And now it's going to get deleted. So after you are done with clearing the folders, you can now double click on 6 uninstalled apps. And in here you're going to see some apps with weird names like Microsoft Edge. So simply just click advanced options, scroll down and click reset, then click reset. Then go back and do the same for every other program that has a weird name or simply just doesn't have its icon. Also, if you installed Firefox, make sure to uninstall the maintenance service since it's so unnecessary. And now that is it for debloating, so now let's install our GPU driver. So I've already installed my GPU driver since I needed to run OBS, but I'm still going to show you how to download them. So if you have an AMD GPU, just double click on AMD drivers. And if you have an NVIDIA GPU, double click on NVIDIA drivers. So for NVIDIA, simply just want to choose your product type. Most of you are gonna have GeForce, and then simply just click your product series. I'm gonna click 30 because I have a 3080. And then under product, select your GPU name. And then here, make sure that Windows driver type is standard. Operating system is Windows 10 64-bit. Then click search. And then you can go ahead and download the 457.30 driver. So at the moment, this is the most stable driver for performance. By time, I will keep updating the most stable driver. But for now, this is the one you want to download. So simply just click on GeForce Game Ready driver beside it. Then click download. And click download. And for AMD, it's gonna be almost the same thing. You simply just wanna choose your GPU. So after you've downloaded the driver, simply just double click on it, then click OK. And after that, if you use GeForce Experience, click this option. And if you don't, click NVIDIA graphics driver. So for this video, I'm not really going to go in depth into debloating GPU drivers. I'm going to do a separate video for that. But for now, you could just click agree and continue. Then click custom, click next. Click perform a clean installation, uncheck HD audio driver and physics X system software, you don't need those at all, then click next. Alright, so happy new year guys, this video took me about 12 hours, maybe more, I actually don't know, but yeah, I hope you'll enjoy this video guys. Soon I have my Windows 10 optimization tweaking guide. It's going to be pretty long, almost the same as this video, but yeah, I hope you all enjoyed it. Make sure to like and subscribe if this video helped you. Stay safe, and I'll see you all in the next one.